Hey everyone, today I would like to share a method for creating fur for your animals or any other objects you would like to use. If you take a look at this mouse, it looks flat. However, in the end, we will achieve something like this. This technique specifically works in HDRP, High Definition Render Pipeline. If you want this in URP or built-in, you will need to have Amplify Shader package, which is a paid asset, and then follow along. To begin, create a lead shader graph. Activate features such as subsurface scattering or double side rendering if you want to. One thing that you should enable is tessellation, a method for subdividing the triangles of your meshes. I'm not sure when Unity introduced tessellation for shader graphs, but I'm using the latest 2022. You should see these two added blocks, tessellation factor and tessellation displacement. I have a video about tessellation and implementing tessellation for train, and I will put the link in the description. Create a main texture, name it diffuse, connect it to the sample texture, and use the hue node to have color variation. Connect the result to the base color. Start with a UV node, use the UV1 channel and multiply it by a fur size. If you are unfamiliar with the function of each node, check out my video on mastering nodes in shader graphs. Use the Voronoi node and a fur density to control the cells. You can maintain the angle of cells or use the time node for a simple animation, serving as our fur movement. And also set the hash type to legacy sign. Reverse the result using a 1 minus node and apply a contrast node to determine the opacity or contrast of our cells. Now let's create a mask for our fur and multiply it by the contrast output. Utilize a normal vector to take each normal direction of triangles and multiply it by a small number to reduce the direction output, and then multiply these two results and connect this final result to tessellation displacement. I can connect the output, and it an issue may be due to the use of sample texture 2D node. Instead, use sample texture 2D LOD. Additionally, create a property for the tessellation factor. return to Unity and assign the shader to the mouse material. There it is, a simple yet performance-oriented fare. Adjust values as needed. For increasing performance, tweak tessellation options. The fare is achieved through tessellation, which will fade when distant, contributing to improved game performance. You can also incorporate a mask, or if you don't have one, you can create in Photoshop or any image editing software. If you want movement in your fare, adjust the fare movement parameter. For creating this effect in Unity, like a plane of dots or a human character with only dots and interacting with it, refer to my video above the screen. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching. Have a great day.